Central Bucks High School South Titan Thespians were set to perform Mary Poppins on April 3rd and 4th, 2020. We auditioned for the show in November and had been working 5 days a week on vocals, acting, building and painting the sets, and executing the exceptional choreography required for this show. We practiced many magical special effects and surprises for the whole family. And like so many other high schools, we were unable to perform this piece live. But tonight, the Titan Thespians want to share with you a piece of this experience, the friendships, the commitment, and the story itself. You will get to see some recorded footage from our rehearsals and our presentation at our Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS performance, along with our live performance this evening. Thank you to the Bucks County Playhouse Student Festival and to everyone watching and supporting us every step of the way. We thank you for sharing this moment with us.
Winds in the east, there's a mist coming in, like something is brewing and about to begin. Can't put me finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen's all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son, their threads or their lies are all raveling undone. Something is needed to twist them as tight as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chimney, chim chim, cherry chim cheru.
Come back here, you little blighters, you've got to do your lessons.
You can't make us, you're only our nanny.
Oi, not you two again. Come along, hoy. Oi.
Good morning, Bert.
Good morning, Miss Lark.
By Jove, is that the beauteous Miss Lark I spy on the horizon?
Morning, Admiral. How's it looking?
Dark clouds gathering over number 17. Storm warnings overdue.
Katie Nana. Katie Nana.
Those little beasts have run away from me for the last time. I've done with this house forever.
And who gets stuck with the children with no nanny in the house? Well, good riddance then.
I thought Katie Nana would be firm with the children. If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
Few women alive could manage Miss Andrews' standards of efficiency. Place an advertisement in the Times for the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
We've written our own advertisement.
What on earth?
Wanted, a nanny for two adorable children. If you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and very pretty. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never feed us castor oil or gruel. Blech.
Love us as a son and daughter.
And never smell of barley water. I put that fit in too.
If you won't scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see.
Put toads in your bed or pepper in your tea.
Hurry, nanny. Many thanks, sincerely. Jane.
And Michael. Thanks.
Good morning.
Yes.
I've come about the advertisement.
What advertisement? We haven't placed her.
By the time the wind has blown the weather vane around, I'll show you if I can. No matter what the circumstance, for one thing I'm renowned. My character is spit, spot, spick, and span. I'm practically perfect in every way. Practically perfect, so people say. Each virtue virtually knows no bound. Each trait is great and paintedly sound. I'm practically perfect from head to toe. If I had a fault, it would never dare to show. I'm so practically perfect in every way.
Mary Poppins proves that she is capable of magical moments and all of the perfection that she promises the children, such as her conversion of an ordinary park into a spectacle of color and joy.
That's not all the children need to learn, however. Magic is fine and fun, but children also need to follow the rules, respect their elders, and be responsible for their playthings. Mary Poppins uses her magic to teach the children a lesson about caring for their toys by bringing them to life.
Are you feeling any better, Valentine?
Much better, thank you.
What happened exactly?
They tore my arm again. They're not playing the game, not playing fair, not with the doll, nor with the bear, thrown on the floor and neglected, and they were to blame. Playing the game.
Please tell them, Mary Poppins.
Those girls and boys.
Those girls and boys.
Who treat us this way.
Who treat us this way.
Don't deserve fun.
Don't deserve fun.
So why should we stay? They stamp and shout.
They stamp and shout.
Create such a fuss. They need to learn the value of us.
Meanwhile, Mary Poppins decides to take the children to visit their father at the bank. The children have never really considered how hard their father works or how difficult it is to be a grown-up.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman.
Good morning. Banks, a word. I see Herr von Hustler is coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. Be sure it's the right one.
Herr Banks, what objections can you have? My security is more than adequate in this expanding market. What's the matter? Have you no courage?
But, Mr. von Hustler, what I haven't been able to grasp is what exactly is your final product?
Have you come to your decision, Mr. Banks? There's a town of good people whose future depends on you.
Hello, Daddy!
What is the meaning of this? Really, Mary Poppins, I am not without a sense of humor.
Aren't you, Daddy?
I would never have dared interrupt my father. Now that's enough. You've seen where I work and I have a great deal to do.
When you invest the bank's money, what are you looking for, Daddy? A good man or a good idea?
Well, I suppose I should say it's a good idea, but a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Read the birds, Toppence a bag. Toppence, Toppence, Toppence a bag. Feed the birds, Toppence. Steps of St. Paul's, the little old bird woman comes in my own special way to the people I call. Come buy my bags full of crumbs. Come feed the little birds, show them you care. And you'll be glad if you do. Their young ones are hungry, their nests are so bare. All it takes is toppings from you. Feed the birds, toppings a bag, toppings, toppings. tuppence, tuppence a bag, feed the birds. That's what I cry while overhead the birds fill the sky.
By far, one of the most memorable experiences that the children had with Mary Poppins is a visit to Mrs. Corey's letter shop, where the children learned that there was a great deal of wonder and creativity in the world, and that their father, when he once was a boy, should an innocent joy in all things too.
Well, if it isn't Mary Poppins with Shane and Michael Banks. Your father George used to come into my shop and buy my gingerbread. Ah, yes. Gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars.
I'd like an ounce of conversations, please.
Annie, Fanny, look lively.
Yes, Mother!
An ounce, you say? That'll be 15 letters.
Thank you. Now, let's see. What words can we make?
Well, I see dog and cat.
Routaplex. That's 9.
Lepiferous. That's 11. Nearly there.
Those don't count. You made them up.
And where do you think all words came from in the first place? Someone had to make them up.
You know, you can always use the same letter more than once. Now let me see. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Soon each men were chatting, simply grunting, what's a fire?
Now if they ever this word, they might have used it once or twice.
Sure, Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a jeep. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it, and wild animals will not seem so ferocious.
Grr.
Add some further flourishes, it's surococococious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for despair. Just summon up this word, and then you've got a lot to say.
Pick out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well, and put them in an order which is very hard to spell.
SUPERCALIF RAGIL
RICXPIALIDOCIOUS
finds that Mary Poppins has vanished, and they are left to determine if she has taught the family anything at all. Winifred Banks laments that it is very difficult to be Mrs. Banks. She wonders if she can gain back her husband's attention if she, perhaps, tracks down and hires his childhood nanny, the cruel and abusive and terrifying Miss Andrew. In the end, Mr. Banks does have the change of heart they'd all hoped for because of a conversation with, surprisingly, Bert the Chimney Sweep.
Being Mrs. Banks, it's easy to forget the way I felt that summer's day, the day that we first met. Being Mrs. Banks, being kissed by you, a man of dreams who made me feel that wishes could come true. And now, although you're lost, it's time that we closed ranks. I'll fight for the man who needs freeing, the real you who no one is seeing, and you'll find a way of just being. Being Mr.
Treacle and carbolic soap, these are the tools of my trade. With spoonfuls of sugar, you don't have a hope of seeing that changes are made. Where manners are chronic, my tincture's the tonic. I'm certain to wipe off a smack. Just pour out a ration in matronly fashion. Brimstone and treacle will work. Your son will go to boarding school at once. And as for the girl, I shall take charge of her myself. I won't stand for whining or whinging or whimpering, crying or lying or sobbing or simpering. I then clear that in these two such bad habits first threaded to throttle, then uncork the bottle. Brimstone and treacle will work. Now show me to my room.
Well, I'll never. So that's where I put them.
What are they?
Stars. Gingerbread stars I hid once for my nanny. I always knew I put them somewhere no one would find them. Trouble was, I couldn't find them either. Funny. I haven't thought about that in years. I'm not usually sentimental.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? I'm not so sure. A man has dreams of walking with giants to carve his niche in the edifice of time before the mortar of his zeal has a chance to congeal. The cup is dashed from his lips. The flame is snuffed the morning. He's brought to rack and ruin in his prime. It's that Poppins woman. She's responsible for all of this.
I know the very person. What's that thing she's always saying? A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. So have yourself an healthy helping every day.
A healthy helping of trouble, if you ask me.
You've got to grind, grind, grind at the grindstone, though childhood's lips like sand through a sieve. And all too soon they've up and grown, and then they've flown, and it's too late for you to give.
What's happened? Something's changed. Her bag is gone.
There's a note, too.
What's it say?
There's a picture of the three of us. She signed it. From Mary Poppins, with a good deal of love.
Mary Poppins?
She's gone.
Gone? How peculiar.
She'll be back. Now, what do you think of this?
It's the best I've ever seen.
Could we go fly together?
Oh, Daddy!
Mary Poppins won't be coming back. She's gone forever.
My dear, how could you possibly know such a thing?
Because we don't need her. Not anymore. And other families will, won't they, Daddy?
They will. Look, wasn't that a shooting star? Wish on it, children.
We won't forget you, Mary Poppins.
We'll never forget.
With tuppence for paper and strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight. With your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
Send it flying up there. All at once, you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees. With your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.